morning, everybody. Buenos días. One of the first times I got the chance to travel far away from what at that time I called home, I went to Honduras. I worked as a social volunteer in a rural education and reforestation project. And every morning at 5:30, when the sun went up, we were climbing with my friends onto the roof of the house we were living in. And we all overlooked a beautiful tropical rainforest valley. There was this meandering river slowly going into the deep green tropical forest. The clouds were coming out in the early morning sun and being dismantled slowly. And an incountable number of parrots or other birds were flying through the canopies, out of the canopy, and just doing circles around the air, around our house, or around our hill. And it was in one of these moments of deep consciousness, of one of these moments where you just feel with your whole being, with your whole soul, that something fundamental is being revealed to you. It was in one of these moments that I could understand what incredible power of life I could find for myself in what nature meant to me. I chose to study forestry. And I think that counts for most of the environmental professions that many of us have here. I chose to study forestry because I wanted to combine two key elements with my profession and in my life in general. And one of them was that I wanted to be able, at any point of my life, at any point of my work, to always relate to this incredible power of life that I found in nature. I wanted to be able to always take it back into my work. And the second thing I wanted to combine was, and remember, when I grew up, you know, forests stand for catastrophic human impact on the environment. So pictures of deforestation and destruction, and I wanted to be able to combine my work with a passion for driving change, with, you know, something to make better in this world, something that I could really like get down to myself and work to make a difference in this world, and at the same time make a living out of that. I was not fulfilled by the education I received at university. And that's not because I wasn't interested in the topic or I found, you know, the education of insufficient quality or anything. Not at all. Actually, all the contrary. But there was something crucial missing. We were dealing with global issues. We were dealing with, you know, deforestation in the tropics somewhere. I was in Germany by that time, so it was very far away. We're dealing with local communities, indigenous communities. We're dealing with innovative technical solutions to climate change, which itself was something pretty big and far away. And it was all somehow very static, very theoretic, and yeah, too far away from my personal reality. I mean, I wanted to play what I was learning. But that missing part we found somewhere else. In the following years, we spent 90% of our useful, powerful energy, as we called it, in one of the most, for me, fabulous, greatest playgrounds I've discovered in my life. And as Abby said, yeah, I was working in the International Forest Students Association. And I guess that's an example of any of the youth groups that are here today present. We found something that were, or the thing that was missing in our education, we found it there. And what we found was, yeah, a platform, a ground to innovate, a ground to to be creative, a ground to, at the end, take action and really do something in our world. And going around with other, going around the world with other fellow students, you know, and be able to, yeah, in an interactive way, that was the way we could really, truly appreciate the knowledge we learned at university. At that same time, it allowed us to explore this, for us, fascinating international world, this fascinating professional world somehow in these big conferences. We organized conferences to our delegation to international conferences. To use a fancy term, we were engaging in youth empowerment processes. And yeah, we debated quite a lot of time, or we tried to debate about topics, yeah, that we tried to understand, and pretty often we pretended to understand at the same time. And here we touch upon an important issue. There is a perception of a big ditch, a wide canyon between the youth and the professional sector. And that counts especially in the land use sector, or to use a more topical term, more sexy term, the landscape sector. This can be overcome, or at least this ditch, this canyon, can be made a little bit smaller. I think today is a great example of how we can achieve this. Events such as the Global Landscape Forum play a double role. On one side, the youth, the professional world, the elders, can help us youth harness and channelize, condense our youth, powerful youthful energy into our work. And at the same time, we can inspire the elders to revive this youthful energy, to revive this youthful energy and this drive for change in their day-to-day work and in their life in general. I'm tired of hearing youth generation are the future. Why? Because it implies youth again to remain as a marginal group. Yes, that group has to be, the youth has to be considered, has to be involved in these processes, because no, youth is power. Youth is colorful. Youth is dynamic. What we require is to be seriously and honestly involved at the center of the processes. And speaking here to us young people, we have to seriously define again what our role is, and find that role that fits to us. A role that is natural to us. And then we have also to demand it, to require it, and actually actively take it and live it. We can start here right now today. And then I was asked to give you some take-home messages, some key messages I, in my life, found always very important, especially in the last years. We are all embedded in a set of barriers, our work, our studies, our culture, our society. Each of us, from time to time, should try to forget who we are, what we studied, what we work, and look into ourselves, deeply into ourselves, and try to understand who we truly are, what drives us, and to understand what our talents are. Because these are using the talents is using the most powerful tool you have inside of you. That is something that is given to you, and that is something you can use to make change in the world. And second, as I said before, we have the wonderful chance in our professions to be able to combine our energy for change with our professions. Don't let your studies and your career drive yourself away from this deep inner force. Instead, use the studies, use the tool you have, use the studies, use your careers as tools to drive the change you want to see in the world. Yeah, I'm very excited to be here, and let's get started. Thank you very much.